We were here.
Well, I think there may have been, we didn't clarify, you know, we didn't state right up front there's a no preaching rule, but we really wanted to hear their feedback, even if some of it was a little bit lengthier than we thought it would be. Speaking of feedback, I wonder if we have any callers coming in. Ed.
Caller, are you there? Hello.
I'm here. Can you guys hear me? I don't know if you picked up.
Yes, indeed. What's your name, caller?
My name's Rich. I'm a Christian. I used to be an atheist. And I had a question for you guys. I was wondering if you could answer it.
Go right ahead, Rich. Are you calling from Florida?
No, I'm calling from California.
Okay. What part of California?
Southern California. I'm over
all
here.
Right.
You know where Los Angeles is at, where we get free lighting from the police helicopters every Friday night?
That's a great description. So,
I used to live in Huntington Beach.
Ah, Joe used to live down there. So Rich, you have a question for us. Go right ahead.
Yes, and I want to say I love your guys' show because I believe it's bringing a lot of people to Christianity. I actually play your show to some of my atheist buddies, and we agree to disagree agreeably on a lot of things. But here's what I see. I was listening to your show. I do enjoy your show, even though I'm a Christian and I disagree with everything. But what I see a problem is why atheists are having a problem getting people to believe in the humanist religion of atheism is that there is no proof or evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. And here's the question. Every time I ask an atheist to provide proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct, they cannot provide it, except you guys on your show, you have said that proof and evidence is important. So here's what I would like to ask. Here's the question.
Go right ahead. We're
answering the question with the question, which atheists always tend to do when I ask this question.
Well,
here's the question.
Well,
notice
okay.
I just said it, and he goes, "Do we?" So here's the question.
Yes,
what
Ed.
Proof or evidence can you guys provide that atheism is accurate and correct? And let's see if you can do it without asking a question with the question. And then I'll tell you how you did.
That's a fair condition, I think.
Because there was no proof or evidence when I looked for it. That's why I left the humanist religion of atheism. But go ahead. I'll listen.
All right. Thank you very much. Well, since I'm going first, atheism accurate and correct? Well,
what proof?
Atheism
no,
is
what
accurate
proof
and correct
or evidence?
Because,
what proof
no,
or
certainly,
evidence?
Certainly, the evidence, first we have to make sure we understand what atheism is, because you keep talking about the humanist religion of atheism, and I think you don't know what you're talking about. You say you were an atheist. You seem to have a very
atheism is not humanism?
You want me to answer? Go ahead and let me
go ahead. What proof or evidence?
Give me a chance to answer first. We have to make sure we're talking about the same thing, Rich, or otherwise we're only going to be talking past one another.
Whatever way you want to – listen, whatever way you want to define it, all I'm saying is what proof or evidence do you have that atheism is accurate and correct?
Fair enough.
It's a very simple question.
I
try not to hem and haw and avoid the question. Just simply answer it. You should have all kinds of proof and evidence. But
well,
I've been
Rich,
on about a minute, and I haven't heard anything.
If you give me a moment to answer, I will do so. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm on the edge of my chair. You'll be the first atheist ever to answer it.
Don't fall off. Very well. We won't touch on your definition. I'll give you my definition.
No, any
definition.
Atheism's madness. So who cares what the definition is? It's madness. But go ahead and go for it. I'll listen to see what
I really appreciate your listening. So atheism is exactly no more, no less than not having a belief in God. The evidence that atheism is correct for me is that I, through introspection, I know for a fact that I do not have any belief in a God. Therefore, I'm an atheist. Atheism is a description.
Where's your
just
proof
like
of that? Where's the proof
my
and
proof
evidence?
That I'm an atheist? You
where's
want,
your proof
are
and
you
evidence?
You want me to prove that
where's
I'm
your proof
an
and evidence that you're avoiding the question? See, typical atheist with a spine of spaghetti, what proof or evidence do you have that atheism is accurate and correct? I ask
the problem, Rich, is that we're atheists because of the lack of evidence for a God.
So there's lack of evidence for atheism. So what proof or evidence do you have that atheism is accurate and correct?
Okay, please, he's talking enough already.
Third time.
Rich, I have answered your question because you keep interrupting me.
Where's
me
the proof?
You didn't supply any proof.
You failed miserably on live radio to provide any proof or evidence that atheism is accurate and correct.
No, this does remind me of last night a little bit. Let's try this without me without you interrupting. Will you allow me to complete a sentence?
As long as the next words out of your sweet, lovable atheist mouth is proof and evidence, we want the world, if we're going to risk denying Jesus Christ and we're going to have to believe in some other type of proof or evidence, you guys are going to have to supply more proof and evidence than Jesus Christ supplied. And what is so good about atheism? Where's the proof and evidence of atheism that would allow a rational person like me, an ex-atheist, who got two things? I got a brain, and I read the Bible. I got a heart, and I humbled myself when I confessed I'm a sinner. So I'm
Thank
not
you.
Hearing any proof or evidence that atheism is accurate. And
I know you're not hearing. You're not taking a pause to breathe. From my point
Go ahead.
Here. Now that you've answered.
Just try not to
do that. Rich, you said define atheism as I do.
No, I did not say define atheism. See, you're lying. Play back the audio. I said, what proof or evidence do you have? Don't lie.
We have this recorded.
How
you
unfair.
You can listen to it later and hear what you said.
Yeah, play it back. Atheism. I never said define atheism. I said, what proof or evidence do you have that atheism is accurate and correct? And I'm going to be really quiet,
Rich,
and I'm going to listen to the proof and evidence. Go
okay.
for it.
Atheism is lack of belief in a God. When I say that atheism is correct, I mean that I don't have any belief in God. Do you understand that so far? Yes or no only, please.
I understand you haven't supplied any proof
Thank
or evidence.
You.
Yes, I understand you haven't supplied any proof
give
or
me
evidence.
A,
yes,
give me
I
a
understand
chance.
You haven't supplied proof or evidence. So
Good
where
Lord,
is it, though?
Competitive. Okay. The
There's
evidence
someone else
that
on the
I,
line that could at least answer the question.
Rich, first of all, the evidence that I don't believe in God is my say-so. I'm saying I don't believe in God because I know that for a fact. The same way if you ask someone, what's your favorite ice
How
cream?
How do you know
they
it
say,
for a
they
fact?
They say it's vanilla.
Where's
How,
your proof?
What's your
Where's
your
proof
that
you
your favorite
know it
ice
for a
cream
fact?
Is vanilla? What is your proof that your favorite ice cream is vanilla? Can you prove
Where's your
that?
Proof
do you
for
have
a
evidence
fact?
For it?
Where's
Rich,
your proof?
You're wasting your time.
Listen. We want proof,
proof
and evidence.
I can
you
give
have
you proof
failed
you
miserably. Listen,
question.
My sweet
you
lovable
have a
atheist.
Mathematical question
this is
me,
why
right?
I left the madness of atheism. It is based on faith.
I really doubt that.
100% faith.
This man doesn't
he
even
understand
what atheism
he
is.
Doesn't. He
but
atheist,
I think
I
you guys
seem
like you're pretty upset now. We have shaken the foundations of atheism. Now that the whole world and everyone on your show knows there is no proof or evidence for atheism.
I can say the same thing for Christians.
Now we're going to give Frank an opportunity to speak. So, Rich, zip it.
It's just a matter of lack
as long
of
as
that.
Am I going to have a chance to talk after Frankie boy here?
Just cut him off. We're going to let Frank talk.
Oh, running from the debate.
No. You're
All
not,
right,
you're
bye.
Not,
well, am I going to have a chance to talk after Frank?
He'd run the show. Just
sure.
Just.
You called in to ask us what we think.
Just mute him. You can mute
no,
him.
No, I asked what proof for evidence. Proof
okay,
and evidence.
Stand by.
Go ahead, Frank.
We have come to our conclusion that there is no God because of the lack of evidence. You know, extraordinary claims like they got in the Bible require extraordinary explanations. And we haven't seen hardly any explanations at all that aren't just drawn from fables. So we have come to the conclusion that there is no God. And everything that happens to man is either accomplished by man or is destroyed by man. There is no God there to guide us.
Okay, and Joe.
Well, that was a failure. That was no proof of evidence. That was opinion. But go ahead. Let's go to Joe. Let's see if he's got something better.
It's like if Frank says, okay, I have $5. I'm like, okay, yeah, that's fine. But if he says, well, I have now, you know, a whole unicorn in my pocket.
A unicorn! Yes!
You
guys have Santa syndrome. You guys have Santa syndrome. That's what it is.
So, I mean, what proof do you have for Christianity?
Okay, I'm going to go ahead and dip my toes in the water, even though you guys, everyone would agree that you have, I'm going to answer a question, even though you guys will agree that you, would you agree you have not provided proof or evidence that atheism is accurate and correct? You've provided opinion?
Well, let
where
me
can I look at the proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct besides the unicorn? What do you, can I ask you a question, too? What do you atheists got with Santa Claus and unicorns? You love them.
Because it's just kind of comparable to Jesus.
Spaghetti monsters.
Well, that, I think that's...
Well, who do you guys think Jesus is? I'll ask you a question. I'm going to let you guys escape the question because you obviously cannot provide proof or evidence on live radio. Well, who do you guys think Jesus Christ is?
You have...
Well, it depends on which Jesus Christ you're talking about. There's the Jesus Christ of the literary Jesus Christ of the canonical Gospels, the Jesus Christ of the Gospels that didn't
make
it into the canon.
So who do you think he is?
Basically... Well, it's basically whatever you imagine. It's who do you think he is?
It's legend.
There are about as many different views of Jesus Christ as there are people. Look at the pictures people draw and the statues people make. Jesus is white. Jesus is black. Jesus is Jewish. Jesus is Aryan. Jesus is whatever
you make up. I can prove to you, God exists.
Jesus, are you ready to listen? You make up in your mind. And the point is, you're asking for proof or evidence of atheism.
No, I'm not. I'm saying that it's accurate or correct.
He seems angry.
I'm not angry at all. I love you guys.
Well,
I used to be an atheist. Do you guys love me?
Hold on one moment. Let's go
back. You guys love
you
me.
Did ask for...
I love you guys.
All right, hold on a second. Hold on,
Rich. Okay, this is our show. We're going to get an engine. We're going to get a word in edgewise. The question that this caller asked was, what proof or evidence do you have that atheism is accurate? Of course, the moment we start touching on that, he immediately interrupts, just repeating himself over and over again like some maniac. Talks about the madness he was in. I don't think he's left it yet. Now, what we need to do, if you're going to give proof or evidence of anything, I'm trained in mathematics. I know what proof is. Proof is something that you demonstrate rigorously. Now, that's great. If someone has a mathematical definition of God, I'm willing to hear it. But let's stick with evidence. The evidence for atheism is the simple fact that people don't believe in a God. Atheism is not a claim that God does not exist. I think that's the basic error that this caller is having. He thinks that atheism is the claim that God doesn't exist. Rich, you're wrong. That's not what atheism is. Atheism is a description of being without God, being without a belief in God. We don't believe in gods. What's there to prove about that? There's nothing that needs to be proven. Now, if you want to say, well, when we're considering the question, is there a God, can you prove there's not one? No, but who cares? I can't prove there's not a million things. I can't prove there isn't a God hiding on the other side of Mars right now. Maybe there is. Maybe there are 10 of them or 20. But that doesn't matter. Just because I can't prove it doesn't mean I have to believe it. It's just like you don't have to believe in Santa Claus or leprechauns or whatever other fairy tales you might imagine, in order not to believe in them. So we have a really basic shifting of the burden of proof. This is a common, very common logical fallacy that so many hysterical religionists make, that they say, oh my goodness, they're contradicting what I believe. Prove that I'm wrong. Well, Rich, I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm not going to prove that you're wrong because, number one, it's impossible to prove something when you can't even define it. Number two, I don't care what you believe. Most atheists don't. If you leave us alone, let us be equal citizens with equal rights, we're happy. And we defend the right of everyone to believe what they will, what they won't, as they choose. At least that's what Atheists of Florida does here in the state of Florida.
I like John Kiefer's bumper sticker. It says, we have the fossils, we win.
Well, that's a different issue.
Should I hang up, or am I on the line?
No, go ahead. We'll give you your.
I didn't want to interrupt you guys. Seriously, guys, I think it's a good. I'm glad you guys have the show. I think it's very important because I have to choose between the most famous person in the world, the most famous book in the world, Jesus Christ of the Bible, or I can believe in the words of Dawkins. Do you guys believe Dawkins is correct when Dawkins says he believes
about
aliens? He believes aliens. Dawkins needs to phone home. Do you know in one of Dawkins' books, he said, hey, come on, guys, I'm talking. You remember when Dawkins said, there's no way, let me do my Dawkins imitation for you. The God of the Old Testament is a bloodthirsty homophobe, an ethnic cleanser, jealous, petty, and proud of it. But the problem is Ben Stein asked him, Mr. Dawkins, where's your evidence that, where's your evidence And he goes, well, I receive letters. Dawkins receives letters? There's over 6 billion people on the planet. The problem is Dawkins says on one hand that God could not exist, then he says that God could exist. So the question I have for you guys is, it sounds like you're saying that God could exist. You guys aren't atheists. You're agnostics. You need to change the show to Agnostics of Florida. Or do you guys totally do you not believe God exists, or do you believe he could exist?
You're not a Christian. You're just a wanna-believer. You don't really believe in Christianity.
Well, actually, I don't hate Jesus. I don't hate Jesus Christ like you guys do.
You don't even love Jesus Christ. You think that Jesus Christ is as mythical as we do.
I don't hate Jesus Christ like you guys do.
Neither do we. Why would you think we hate a mythical being?
And you know what? I'll tell you something, Rich. I'm one of the atheists who does say there is no such thing as God, because I understand that all of the 20,000-plus gods that have ever been dreamed up by our species were all just the imaginations of the people who dreamed them up. The very word God is just a fantasy. It has no meaning
or
substance.
Well, you guys have not provided proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. And on my radio show, I do a radio show also. I'm not going to interrupt and give my site out here because I don't want to disrespect your show. But on my show, I invite atheists to call in and provide proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. And just like you guys, no offense, I love you guys, but you have failed miserably to provide
evidence. That's because
evidence
you shifted the goalpost after we gave you the evidence.
No, you said it on your show. You said it. I got audio of you saying proof and evidence. You said it. You guys are hypocrites.
You
said on your show, I got audio of you saying that you need to provide proof and evidence. Well, you guys, you need to provide proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. I'm going to give you one last chance.
Already
I'm not going to talk. Go ahead and provide proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. Go ahead.
Okay.
I'll listen to the show.
That question was asked and answered. The fact that atheism
you never answered it. What'd you say?
Look,
what was the proof? Where is it? Where can I find this proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct?
Our next caller. Come on.
All right. We got another caller, Rich. Nice to hear from you.
Thanks for running from the show.
Hey guys, this is Shock. I hope you enjoyed my call into the radio show. As an ex-atheist, I believe it is good and it is moral and it is right to expose the madness of atheism. It offers nothing but Santa Claus, unicorns, and leprechauns. It is insanity with a mix of arrogance. Here's some of the final comments on the show. When I was off the show, notice they talk behind my back and dishonestly rephrase my question. My question was, what proof or evidence can atheists provide that atheism is accurate and correct? Listen closely how they change the subject, and they lie on live radio and say I was asking about the definition of atheism. Very dishonest. But I think we accomplished our goal. We have proven that atheism is madness.
So we've covered a lot tonight. I think our first caller was the most lively. He wanted to redefine atheism for us.
He did, you know, and even though he said he used to be an atheist, he had no clue.
You hear that all the
time.
Yeah, that's one of the common things a lot of preachers do too.
That's a common tactic, and they will not, whatever definition you give them, they will not accept it, and they will.
But I think it, he may have been sincere though, because he may have been sincere and just, you know. A lot of people, they don't know much about atheism. When I was 16, I became an atheist, but I didn't think of myself as an atheist. I didn't use the word
right. Because
I had been exposed to the idea that atheism was this very particular thing. It's like the denial of God.
Right.
I'm saying, well, I don't deny a God. I just don't happen to believe in any of them.
Well, I didn't even know what the word atheism was until I was 45 years old.
See, so
then I discovered I had been an atheist all my life.
There you go. And by atheist, just to remind anyone listening, it just means don't have any belief in any God.
All of a sudden, you get all these new
people coming up, these new Christians are coming up, I used to be an atheist, and now I used to believe in this evil evolution, this and that, and so I'm like, oh, just because you believed in evolution, you were an atheist? Oh, come on. It's ridiculous.